If you guys need Madden coins, go to MrMuckCoin.com. Use code Ryan50 at checkout for 50% additional coins added onto your order. Yo, what is going on, you guys? Welcome back to another Madden 19 video. Now, today we have the Madden Deep Dive gameplay and real player motion. Of course, we just got the gameplay trailer at E3. And, you know, we're going to have a little bit of pop-ups here from YouTube, from you guys commenting. But we do have the Madden Deep Dive gameplay and real player motion article here on EASports.com. I will have the link to the description below if you guys want to see everything for yourself. But it says, gameplay in Madden 19 was developed with two primary objectives. Back to Madden after your Cavs quit, commented by Corey Andy 5. That's nice. Gameplay in Madden 19 was developed with two primary objectives, player control across the field, immersive NFL experience from start to finish. To achieve these objectives, our goal is to deliver the most significant animation upgrade in Madden history. Madden NFL 19 introduces a package of features known as Real Player Motion, featuring authentic player movement, more player control and responsiveness, and player signature behaviors that will immerse players in the NFL each and every game. So, basically, I'm just going to do a little breakdown of everything after I read it. Pretty much what that means is, you know, how you play Madden in the past, every player kind of feels like the same player. It's just updated ratings. They're a little bit faster. They're a little bit, you know, quicker. They catch the ball a little bit better. Everyone kind of feels the same way in Madden 18 and, you know, Madden 17, Madden 16, Madden 15. You know what I'm talking about, right? Like, everyone kind of feels the same. What they're trying to go for now is everybody will feel like their actual real-life counterpart. So if you catch a ball with Antonio Brown, he's going to feel like Antonio Brown. If you catch a ball with Julio Jones, he's not going to feel like Antonio Brown. He's going to feel like Julio Jones. Like, it should be. You should be able to have real time, you know, animations, real player motion. It makes them feel exactly like they do when you watch them on TV. You're going to know exactly who you're playing with when you get the ball into their hands, and I think that's great. So we actually had a little bit of that with, like, quarterback throwing motions and quarterback cadences in the past, but now it looks like we're going to get really 100% authentic animations, and that is awesome. So real player motion, locomotion, player locomotion or run cycles is the feature that is going to have the biggest impact on Madden gameplay. The locomotion system has been rebuilt using technological innovations from across a variety of EA games and was designed in a way that intuitively balances the line between responsiveness and authenticity. The new locomotion system delivers a precision of making sharp cuts versus rounded turns based on button inputs. Want to make a sharp cut up the field before stepping out of bounds near the sideline? Let go of RT/R2, acceleration burst, and move the left stick in the desired direction to cut sharply on a dime. That sounds awesome. Want to run at full speed? Making minor movements to avoid losing momentum? Hold down RT/R2 acceleration burst to carve through the defense. So definitely letting go of R2/RT and then moving the stick in the desired position makes it seem like you could do like a back juke again really quickly, or a stutter step motion, or a quick step to the left, quick step to the right. Maybe a quick step diagonally. It looks like you have full player control, which is exactly what we need in Madden. It's going to make gameplay a lot better. Managing the acceleration burst mechanic will have the biggest impact on the way you play Madden. When used, acceleration burst will take your player to top speed based on his ratings, but prevent you from making drastic direction changes without losing speed. That sounds amazing. When not accelerating using only the left stick to move your player, you can make sharp, precise cuts and drastic direction changes, but cannot run at top speed. That makes a lot of sense. This change in speed transitions allows you to be in full control over how you want your player to move on the field while offering the most visually authentic locomotion we've ever had. So it's making pretty clear right now that being able to control your acceleration with the R2/RT button on Xbox, it's going to have a lot of impact on how you play the game, a lot of different cuts you can make, and you know, you have to make a decision based on how you feel you need to currently go about how you want to make a defender miss. If you want to just accelerate through a hole, you could just, you know, like in past Madden, just hold down R2/RT and just accelerate as fast as you can through the hole. That's what a lot of people do, but now there's a lot more emphasis on you don't want to always do that. You want to be able to make cuts. You want to be able to know exactly when you want to jam that RT, R2 button to, you know, accelerate. definitely going to be really, really cool. It says, in addition to the movement benefits, players' run cycles will be visually and functionally separated based on each player's height, weight, position, and ratings. These are multiple versions of run cycles in Madden 19 so that each player will feel and look unique. A big bruising fullback may have to take a few extra steps to make that sharp cut up the field, as opposed to a short, shifty scat back who can quickly put his foot in the ground and go. So now, guys like Derrick Henry, which are 6'3", can't make the same type of cuts that a, you know, 5'11" running back could make. Derrick Henry is going to be more of a giant running back that'll bruise through defenders. Only he will be able to do that, as well as like LeGarrette Blount and other big time running backs. But a smaller scat back like, you know, Darren Sproles, for example, Donnell Pumphrey, guys like that, they're going to be able to really, really show off their scat back mentality. They'll be able to show off how quickly they can actually run through, you know, holes and, you know, make people miss and whatnot with quick cuts. One cut. Speaking of putting your foot in the ground and going, one cut is a new ball carrier move that does not, that does just that by leveraging the skill of acceleration burst with precise, with precision of the new player locomotion, inspired by one cutbacks in zone schemes and further supported by Minnesota Vikings wide receiver Stephon Diggs' miracle play in the playoffs. This mechanic unlocks the ability to burst out of a controlled cut on a drastic direction change upfield. So while you're making that cut, you could actually burst up the field and, you know, hold down that R2 button and just quickly accelerate. When making these cuts, there will be a small timing window open to activate a faster version of the acceleration burst as the outside plant foot hits the turf. So if you could time it correctly, then you could actually just take off super quick, is what I'm guessing this means. Simulating the burst ball carriers when sticking their foot in the ground and hitting the hole. But beware, this mechanic is so powerful, it comes with a heavy stamina hit. So you'll have to be smart about when to deploy the move, as you most likely will only have the energy to pull off only one in a single play. The speed and effectiveness of one cut is, of course, tailored to fit each player's individual ratings and scales per your difficulty level. So pretty much it's going to be like a modified type move where it takes away mostly all your stamina. And then, of course, Mutt will have the ability to nullify that by, you know, probably having energized in the game where once you pull off the move, it'll pull your stamina all the way back up to 100 so you could keep doing it over and over if you want to. That's going to be super overpowered. Energize might be the best chemistry in Madden, the best chemistry ability in Madden if they bring back abilities. Strafe Burst. The defensive counter to one cut, Strafe Burst, is a very similar in its look and feel, as it will allow your defender to have a similar ability to quickly accelerate out of a foot plant to make to go make a play. So pretty much if someone is doing that acceleration burst on offense, you could actually do it with the defender as well to quickly accelerate out of his foot plant and go chase him down and get him down. When holding L2/LT to strafe on defense, you can accelerate out of the strafe and into a sprint by releasing the strafe button and quickly activating the acceleration burst using R2. It uses the same timing window as one cut. Mastering this mechanic will give your defender the ability to make a play on the one cut in the open field while carrying a similar stamina hit. Branching special moves. In Madden 19, you could chain together ball carrier special moves and make a smooth transition from one to another before each one is complete. You want to quickly transition from a juke to a spin and back to a juke. Real player motion allows the freedom and creativity for our players to take their best shot at putting out some of the best highlight videos ever seen. And here, this is making me super happy, seeing the new Tennessee Titans uniforms here. They're highlighting Deion Lewis as the person that, they're pretty much making the poster boy of the juke spin juke. Definitely Deion Lewis, a very shifty running back. Can't wait to see him in Madden. Really loving how the uniforms look here in the game. Looks like we're going up against the Jaguars, which is making me happy. Hit the hole. Traditionally, one of the areas of the game where our players felt like they commonly lost control is when navigating through tight gaps in the trenches on running plays. Real player motion allowed us to make new ball carrier mechanics to ensure more player control at this critical point in the run game. Known as hit the hole, this right stick mechanic that is contextual extension to the existing juke system. When running through the line, if you want to make a quick direction change to get through the gap in the line, flick the right stick towards that gap and you will see your ball carrier make a contextually appropriate direction change into the gap that will get him through quickly and efficiently without tripping over his linemen or getting stuck behind them. So that is definitely something we have needed in Madden. And we used to have a thing where you can get skinny through the hole, but now we actually have a way to hit the hole correctly. Hopefully the AI will actually do it the right way as well. If, you know, we're playing against like CPUs and whatnot, or, you know, maybe if we, you know, are just pressing the button up, maybe we won't have full control of it. Maybe the AI is actually going to have to decide what to exactly do. The player skill here lies with recognizing when an open gap exists or not. If you flick the stick towards a gap that is closed, your ball carrier will still make the direction change, but instead of squeezing through the line, he'll be tackled instead. Push the pile. So pretty much, I'm just going to go ahead and break this down just by reading a little bit of it. I don't want to read the full thing anymore. It's going to be too long of a video. But it's pretty much the same thing as hit the hole. Push the pile is a new ball carrier mechanic that fits the same objective as player control. So pretty much, push the pile is an extension of the truck stick mechanic. If you want to engage your running back into the back of a blocker to just push forward or guide the blocking engagement out of your way to gain space, simply hold the right stick up as you make contact with the blocker to get into the push the pile interaction. So pretty much, this is going to be more for like a bruising running back, again, like Derrick Henry, like LeGarrette Blount. You could actually put your hand on a blocker and push the pile forward. And that's going to be really cool to see. It's definitely going to have, you know, like hit the hole and, you know, special moves and whatnot for, you know, more shifty running backs. And then pushing the pile, you know, breaking through blockers, breaking through defenders, that's going to be more so the power backs. Catching improvements. So a lot of feedback standpoint of delivering more freedom for the user. Common player feedback around getting pulled into a catch interactions you didn't ask for, watching receiver jump high in the air and not being able to defend him when you're trying to knock the ball out. To address those, we've introduced a new mid-air collision system for receivers who like to high point the ball, and new additions to the catching system to give more player agency when you're using your receiver. So pretty much, they've added a mid-air collision system for people that like to, you know, throw the ball up and just try to have their receiver get the ball. Now it's going to be even harder to make catches on, you know, deep passes. Defenders will have more control to decide between interacting with the receiver during the catch or afterwards. Play receiver is now all about hitting the receiver hard to make sure he doesn't come down with the ball. On offense, you'll have more time to make your decision about the catch you want to react later in the play to make your final choice. So pretty much, you're going to have more time to decide if you want to do a rat catch, an aggressive catch, a possession catch, so on and so forth. So it's going to be pretty cool to see how that all pans out. Animation quality. In addition to making the game feel authentic, we've also done a lot of work on making the game look authentic. Real player motion is more than just stick mechanics and player control. This new technology also has allowed us to build features that keep you in the moment all game long. Check out a few of the highlights below. So we have tackling. When looking at the core fundamentals in Madden for the tackling, as far as it says, has far and away gotten the biggest visual upgrade. So these are all animations. So pretty much, there's a new momentum tackle. It looks like it says here, you know, based on your speed, your height, and your weight, there's going to be a different type of tackling system. So if you're a bigger guy, you're going to be hitting the ball carrier a little bit harder. If you're smaller, there's probably going to be different ways to use your momentum to actually get them down. That's exactly what it's saying here while I'm just proofreading it. If the running back is trying to change directions and gets popped by a big linebacker running downhill, the running back will take the force of the hit and fall down in the appropriate manner. So the bigger your guys are, the harder you're going to hit them. The smaller your guys are, the, you know, less they're going to hit them. The least amount of force is going to be used. They will no longer go into a ragdoll state or fall down while looking unaware of the game situation. These players will remain active in the play, and their bodies will act according to the laws of physics and momentum. So pretty much, everything is going to be a lot better in this game from basically what I'm seeing. Hopefully, there's not a lot of glitches, though. Lastly, we did a complete refresh of all the hit stick animations. Every hit stick in the game will be new and use the momentum tackle system to ensure the same visual quality we expect with all of our tackles. Some new features also come in with hit stick improvements. You can now attempt to hit stick a receiver during a catch, but be careful not to be early or you'll be flagged for pass interference. So that's also really, really cool. I love how they added that. Signatures. Beyond the features, we've built in-game physical immersion. We also wanted to deliver some personality to go with it. There's two new features we're introducing in Madden 19 that deliver on player signature. QB pre-play signatures and user-controlled celebrations. So quarterback signatures here. Pretty much what it's saying is Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers adjusts his thigh pad all the time. Kansas City Chiefs quarterback Patrick Mahomes is very deliberate when making pre-snap adjustments. All of these behaviors will be reflected in Madden 19 on multiple levels, including contextual fidgets, functional pre-snap adjustments, and audio. All supported quarterbacks will have contextually correct on-field wires associated with each signature animation. We're launching with a handful of NFL quarterback fully supported. So pretty much they will have a set amount of quarterbacks that'll have the actual things that they do in-game, their cadences, the way they fidget in the pocket, the way they make their audibles, the way they make their hot routes, everything about how a quarterback does what they do in real life will be added into Madden 19. And there'll be a set amount of them that'll have it right away. And then they'll probably add more and more as time goes on. But user-controlled celebrations. So here we have the ability to celebrate, with a team, a team group celebration, a spike, a player signature celebration, a dance, and then swagger. Steal a signature animation from the opponent's team. So that is going to be really cool to see how that pans out. Definitely love it that new animations for celebrations are going to be in the game, and you could actually control which one you want to do. So some of them are Duck Duck Goose, the bobsled, the safe breaker, and of course the mini versions of the Gronk Spike. You will see a wide variety of celebrations that you see on Sunday, and we will continue to update this content all year long via post-launch updates. So, and then we also have a whole bunch of new coverages here that they've probably made adjustments on. So we've added new rule sets for Cover 4, Cover 3, Cover 2, as well as other improvements. Here are some of the changes we've made. So Cover 4, we have two new versions of Cover 4, quarters and palms. Quarters and palms are commonly referred to as man-match defenses, which simply means the defenders in coverage can match up and play man-to-man. Both coverage concepts are similar, but with two key differences. Against a formation where a slot receiver is present, and if the slot receiver runs a quick out, the defense in Cover 4 quarters will handle this route with the quarter flat player. The same scenario with Cover 4 palms, the defense will handle this route with the cornerback who's playing outside quarter. In a sense, the coverage plays like a Cover 2. So that sounds great. Cover 4 can actually now be played as a Cover 2 if a specific thing happens with a route. That's definitely, I absolutely love to see that. Cover 3. An emphasis was placed on improving the logic for curl flat defenders and adding rule sets for standard Cover 3 so it's better equipped to handle route concepts from trips and bunch formations. So people that run bunch every single play, you'll be able to run Cover 3 and actually kind of contain it a little bit more. When the offense aligns in a trips bunch formation, Cover 3 match, Cover 3 sky, and Cover 3 buzz plays will function more like the Cover 3 Mabel plays from Madden 18. Tampa 2. The primary focus with Cover 2 was adding new rules and logic for the middle read and vertical hook defenders. The middle read player will now do a much better job of getting to the deep middle of the field to defend against pass routes across the area. So you no longer really have to put him into a deep blue. We also continue to work with our cloud flat players in regard to defending high-low route concepts and with new press animations. That sounds really cool. Protect the sticks. The Protect the Sticks mechanic has been overhauled and updated with new logic. Now underneath defenders and zone covers will spot drop the depth of the first down marker. So Protect the Sticks is now updated. The defensive scheme in new place, or the defensive scheme continues as we add a new defensive formation called the Big Nickel over G. This formation uses a 4-2-5 personnel, which is 4 down linemen, 2 linebackers, 5 defensive backs. 3 of the defensive backs are safeties, less the name Big Nickel. The formation contains new plays and coverage concepts. And this is all from Clint Oldenburg, the lead gameplay design. And definitely everything sounds super awesome. I love the fact that they've added player customized animations. Everything is going to feel authentic when you play Madden. I can't wait to see how it all pans out. And if you guys want to see more Madden info as it drops at E3 and more articles are released, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And I will be here giving you guys all the information as I can as it drops. I will catch you guys later. Peace.